Good morning, guys, or good afternoon. I'm gonna talk about base coats and top coats. A couple of you guys did suggest for me to do this video, and I do normally mention them at the end of my monthly manis video, but it makes a heck of a lot more sense for me to have a separate video and kind of an overall view of what I use. So I'll start off with these two right here. These are the ones that I tend to reach for the most. This one right here is the Creative Nail Designs Sticky Base, and it's labeled as C&D Sticky here at the top. This one is exactly what it's called. It's a sticky base. So when you put this on your nails, on your clean nails, this will adhere to your nails and it dries to a sticky finish. So when you go on with your polish will adhere to this base, which then results in a longer lasting manicure. And when I have needed my manicures to last a little bit longer, I find that this works really well. It prevents chipping from me. It doesn't prevent tip wear ever. I don't think there's any base coat or top coat that will prevent that for me. This one has also been serving a completely different purpose lately because I've been peeling my polish off of my nails, which is a horrible habit and it's very damaging to the nails. But this one, I find that it tends to fight with me, so it starts coming off in little chunks, which then annoys me and it stops me from wanting to peel it off. It's also on the more thinner side. It's very liquidy, it's very watery looking, and so when you put it on your nails, it goes on very thinly and it dries really quickly. The Orally Bonder is labeled as a rubberized base coat, but essentially it also dries sticky. I do find that even when the bottle is full, it's a smidge thicker than the Creative Nail Designs one, so it does take a little bit longer for it to dry. It's not something that actually bothers me, but what I do find different from this one is that I can actually peel strips off of my nail. So I find that this one adheres a little bit better, more so than this one, although it does help my manicure last a little bit longer. But because they both dry sticky, these are not something that I would recommend that you sleep overnight with. These are something that you need to go in with a polish straight away in order to seal it in. Otherwise, you're gonna wake up with little fussies on the nails, and the sun is going in and out, of course. My OPI Natural Nail Base Coat, this is one that's actually done, but I still want to talk about it because I've had this one forever. And this one right here, it's good. I had no issues with it at all. I just always found myself reaching for these two more than this one right here. This one is not a sticky base. It completely dries off, so that's a benefit. If for some reason you put your base coat, something comes up, you don't have a chance to paint your nails, it gives you ample time for you to go in with the polish later. I have noticed that my manicures will last a little bit longer with this one. Again, when I have needed them to, it's not really often that I wear polish for an entire week. And I do find that this one is a lot thicker, not too much, but a little bit thicker than the sticky ones, which then in my mind, I like it because then it gives me a thicker barrier between my nail and the actual polish that's going over top of it. Just because my nails are really absorbent and they tend to stain fairly quickly or fairly easily. So no complaints about this one. I'm just not running out to buy it. Nail strengtheners are something that I've used for years. My sister actually introduced me to the Nailteeks formula. This was ages ago, and at first when my nails really needed it, I started off with the formula 1, and then I graduated to the formula 2, and I just used that one for forever. Initially I was using them every single day, but as my nails got really strong, I only used them for maintenance maybe a couple times a week. I'm out of the Nailteeks one, so I'll pop a picture up here for you guys. The one that I'm using right now is from OPI, and it's their Nail Envy. And I normally get the one with the green writing, and the base looks a little foggy looking, but this one I found at TJ Maxx. And because I'm only using them for maintenance, for strengthening my nails, I just got this one, and it's been working really well for me. These are not something that I reach for longevity. I actually don't really find that it changes anything in my polish, but it's not something that I tend to rely on for a longer lasting manicure. It's just for treatment purposes. One that I need to try, this was a great reminder. I bought this, I think I hauled this at the beginning of the year. This is the Pro FX Sticky Base Coat, which you can find at Walmart. And I actually bought this one because I wanted to compare it to these two right here, but I haven't tried it. So let me know if you guys have tried it and what you guys think about it, because I haven't really looked up or bothered to look up any kind of reviews or anything. I'm just hoping it's promising. The only peel-off base coat that I have is from Sally Hansen, and funny enough, I have a backup of this one. This is my backup right here. I have another one in use. This one I use when I want to put on chunkier glitters, and if you've ever worked with chunkier glitters, they are a pain to remove. It takes about, I don't know, 20-30 minutes to remove the polishes off of your nails. This makes it really easy because it completely, I find that at the third day it starts kind of lifting here at the edges, and then you just lift it up and it completely pops off without damaging your nails. Though very different from me peeling my polish off of my nails, this does it in a safe way where it doesn't damage the nail bed. So I really do like it. I don't find myself having to want to go buy anything else or try anything else because I have this one. It's been serving its purpose, plus I have a backup now, so it's been working really well. But it doesn't work for a long lasting manicure. At 3 days it starts lifting. Moving on to top coats here, I have the INM Out the Door. This is great and I've used it for years. This is fast drying and it gives me that gel looking manicure. Whenever I have gone in to buy a new model, I don't find that it gets thick up until I get towards the bottom of here, so I really like it. I do get some bubbles here and there. I'm finding that I'm getting more bubbles now because this is, I'm using the mama size here, which I refill into this one. So fresh top coat is going into thickening top coat here. So it freshens it up a little bit, but I'm finding that it's getting thicker as I'm going. But that's only because I'm refilling. If you were to go in and buy, you know, a bottle like this, it shouldn't start getting thick, at least for me, up until this point right here. So really like it. Of course, it's fast drying to the touch. If you're ever using fast drying top coats, I would also always recommend that you make sure that you let each layer dry or give it ample time to dry, because although this is fast drying, it's going to be fast drying to the touch. If the layers underneath it are not completely dry and you press onto your nail, you're going to leave an indentation, and that's not an issue with the top coat. That's just an issue with the drying time that you've allowed for your manicure. The Sally Hansen Insta Dry, this is a great top coat. I have it on today. It gives me really great shine. It's thin. It's not going to give you the gel finish look, but it is going to give you great shine, good gloss. This one I tend to use more as like a follow-up to spruce up my manicure because it's on the thinner side. So normally I'll go in with the INM one, and in the following days, if I need to revive my manicure, I'll go in with this. I never like to go in with this because then my manicure starts looking really thick. So this is a good one. Another gel one that I've used is the Pro FX Supreme Gel. This is the Extra Thick Shine Top Coat. And this is the same brand as this sticky base. Again, you can find both of these at Walmart. This one is even more gel. It gives me more of that gel finish on my manicure. You can see how thick that is. It's super thick. It's high shine, and your manicure will stay glossy for quite a few days. But this is not fast drying like the INM one, so you do need to allow it like a good 10 minutes for it to completely dry. I have found with this one from the very beginning though that I get more bubbles than I do with the INM one, and as it's getting thicker, because now I'm towards the middle here, I'm getting even more bubbles. So I'm not a fan of that, but still a really good top coat. Two mattifying top coats that I have here. This is the Sally Hansen Big Matte Top Coat. Somehow I ended up with two of these, and I'm not happy about that because this is not my favorite. This is too inconsistent for me. Sometimes it'll mattify my nails and sometimes it won't. And I've played with it several times and it's just really frustrating to work with this one. With this, the directions on the bottle here are to put a thin coat and not go over it again in order for it to mattify. But for me, what I'll do is I'll put one swipe on one side of my nail and then I'll go in with another swipe on the other side of the nail. And if I overlap on the initial side that I applied it, it won't mattify for me. It's really frustrating. And sometimes what has happened is my pinky, this will cover my entire pinky, and sometimes it'll get matte and sometimes it won't. I don't know what the problem is with it. I'm not sure. I've played with it several times and it's too inconsistent with me and I just don't have the patience for it. So the one that I love and use is the OPI Matte Top Coat. I have never had a problem with this one. If I ever need to go with a second layer of it, which I rarely do. I don't actually need to do that. With one layer, it mattifies your manicure. But if I was to ever go in with two coats, it always mattifies. It always works for me. So I would rather pay this price than have something that's cheaper. And not that the price matters, because I'm sure there's another matte top coat that's inexpensive that works. This one just doesn't work for me. So I love this one. And that is everything. That's everything that I have to share with you guys today. I thank you guys so much for watching. Please make sure to leave down below what you guys love using. I know I've heard about the HK Girl top coat. I have yet to try that one. And if you guys have tried this, let me know what you guys think about it. I thank you guys again so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.